Well, Dussera is all about the victory of good over evil in every aspect of our life, and that includes money matters. So we at ET Now and we on The Money Show decided to talk about the evils when planning for your finances that do tend to creep in the form of biases or otherwise. The evils that do tend to creep in your portfolio. It may be in terms of too much diversification or too less of it. The evils when it comes to excluding certain important items in your portfolio as well. And that may be a health insurance or even a plain vanilla term insurance for that matter. It's important that you adopt the correct money habits while shooting down the ones that are not right for your overall financial health. You could call it the 10 evils of your financial portfolio. That's what we on The Money Show want to discuss, and to do that we have with us Mrin Agarwal, the founder director of FinSafe Advisory. Mrin, it's always a pleasure having you with us on The Money Show, and on behalf of all of us, I'd like to wish you in advance a very happy Dussera. So Mrin, let's start off first with the 10 good financial habits, if you could call it that, that all of our viewers must have regardless of their source of income or their quantum of income.
Well, first and foremost, of course, it's really important to have a savings mindset. I think the biggest issue today really is the fact that people don't end up saving enough, and that's why they're really not able to invest. So first and foremost, you really, really need to have that mindset that I'm going to save at least 30% of my salary every month. And of course, I think the other good financial habit that we really don't talk about much, but it is very important, is before you invest, read. And in fact, in today's environment where we are seeing so much happening, I think it's about reading and asking, you know, and asking questions. Because what I typically see is that we read up some information, but we don't tend to ask any questions, and we don't tend to research more about products. So I think that's point number two. The third thing really is to look at taking on some risk, because I still meet so many people who don't want to take risk. They still want to stick on to traditional investments. Again, in today's environment, with the gold values really rising, it's really going to be very difficult for people to just plan a portfolio based on very safe instruments. So that's point number three. Point number four is really about working with a financial planner. Work with a fee-only financial planner and create a financial plan. Point number five would be about having financial goals. You know, a lot of people I see keep saying that I want to retire, but they really don't have a goal in mind in terms of when they want to do it or what is the amount that they need. So they need to be having quantifiable financial goals. Of course, as I said, you need to save. So if you need to save, it means that you really need to be very, very careful about all the debt that you have on you. That's another really, really important thing that you need to look at. As we are seeing, the household debt is growing at a much faster pace than household savings. And that's really driven a lot by things like credit card loans and personal loans. And since it is the festive season, and I know it's very easy to get these loans, but you need to think about what is the interest rate on the loans that you're paying, and is it really worth it to buy something taking a personal loan. So I think these are some really important points that that I think people should keep in mind.
Okay, well, some very interesting tidbits right there about what exactly is it that you should keep in mind when you go to create a financial portfolio, but also if you have an existing financial portfolio, what are those 10 evils, if you could call it, that could not just perhaps negate your returns, but at least not let your portfolio fulfill the potential return that it can deliver. Very interesting tidbits there. Now, of course, Mrin, what should you then have in your portfolio? I know there are five must-haves and 5 avoids in a particular financial portfolio. And I'm talking about individual instruments, equity, debt, loans, etc. So ideally, Imran, let's split it up between must-haves and must-not-haves. Let's start off first with the must-haves. What are the 5 financial instruments or those products that you believe that every investor should have in their portfolio?
Well, of course, the most important thing is to cover the risk on your life. Obviously, protection comes first before your financial planning. So, of course, having a term plan in place, having a good amount of medical cover in place is important, followed by certain instruments which I think can be in any portfolio irrespective of your wealth, which is PPF for sure. The other instrument is really equity and debt mutual funds. This is pretty much it. And of course, you also need to have a emergency fund kept aside. So essentially, it's your insurance, which is your life insurance and your medical insurance. It's emergency fund that can be accessed in case of any problem. And this could be in form of a liquid fund. If you have a lot of gold, it could be in form of gold as well. Equity and debt funds, of course, very, very important. And I think PPF is a very good instrument that's available, especially for those who are not salaried. I think PPF is a great instrument to own.
Okay, so just to reiterate again for the benefit of all our viewers, equities naturally, because they are one of the few instruments that have the potential to beat inflation, and that certainly is extremely important. You need an inflation beating instrument, and then that's also followed on by medical insurance and term insurance. Remember, both are different. Term insurance, as simple as it gets, a plain vanilla insurance product that secures your and your family's life in the eventuality of your passing. A medical insurance naturally is something that will cover you in case of serious illnesses. You have an emergency funds that parked in ultra short-term funds. A very simple, a simple practice to follow. Take a bit of your monthly income or salary, put it away for a rainy day. And then, of course, you have your PPF. A very simple product, very, very tax efficient as well. That not only provides you tax saving when you invest, but it's tax-free when it comes to interest accrual, tax-free when you withdraw it as well. And by the way, it's currently offering some of the most attractive returns when you compare it versus other small saving schemes. But now, of course, Mrin, we also must ensure that we do not have certain items in our portfolio. So, Mrin, what are the 5 items that one must not have in their portfolio, or if they do have it, should try and eliminate it ASAP?
Well, I think firstly, of course, any instrument that's not tax efficient, which means that any instrument which is taxed at a very high rate, like for example, fixed deposits, company deposits, NCDs, all of these are taxed at your marginal rate of taxation. So I think non-tax efficient investments which are taxed at a high rate are certainly a big no. Again, investment-linked insurance policies are a big no, because due to the high cost, the returns on these policies are pretty low. Within the mutual fund space, there are certain types of funds which are a big no. For example, sector funds, because with sector funds, a particular sector may or may not perform over a period of time. It could be extremely volatile, and essentially by getting into a sector fund, you're not diversifying. So sector fund, to my mind, is a big no. Similarly, on debt funds, things like gilt funds, there are certain funds which are essentially meant only for institutional categories, and I think gilt funds falls in one of them. So I think that, of course, is a big no. Things like loans other than home loans, like for example, personal loans, and especially unsecured loans like personal loans, credit card loans, or loans that you get on e-com company websites, I think are a really big no. And finally, you know, you'll be surprised to know this, that people still invest money in chit funds. So I think a lot of these instruments like chit funds or unregulated instruments, even company deposits, to my mind, are like a really big no because of the concentration risk and the credit risk.